Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 23A, Example 3. In this example, we want to solve the quadratic inequality 5x squared plus 2x is less than or equal to 0 by using the test point method, write our answer in interval notation, and graph the solution set. In step 1, we want to write the quadratic inequality in standard form. The standard form for a quadratic inequality is just like the standard form for quadratic equations, ax squared plus bx plus c, either less than or greater than 0. The reason we are doing this is 0 is our magic number. It is the only number that separates the negatives from the positives. If an expression is greater than 0, then there's no doubt that its sign is positive. Likewise, if it is less than 0, its sign is negative. We cannot say this about any other number. Since we are working with inequalities, this idea will come in handy. With this technique, we will be looking at the sign of a number to determine if it is a solution or not. This inequality is already in standard form. In step 2, we want to set up what we found in step 1 as a quadratic equation and solve it to get the boundary points. The boundary points will mark off where the quadratic expression is equal to 0. This is like the crossover point, since 0 is neither positive nor negative. Our equation will be 5x squared plus 2x equals 0. We can factor a greatest common factor of x and get x times 5x plus 2 equals 0. Using the zero product principle, we can set each factor equal to 0 and get x equals 0 or 5x plus 2 equal to 0. In the first linear equation, our answer is x equals 0. In the second linear equation, we can subtract 2 from both sides and get 5x plus 2 minus 2 equals 0 minus 2, which will simplify to be 5x equals negative 2. Dividing both sides by 5, we get 5x over 5 equals a negative 2/5, which simplifies to be x equals a negative 2/5. So it looks like we have two boundary points, negative 2/5 and 0. In step 3, we want to use the boundary points from step 2 to mark off test intervals on the number line. Here we have marked off our boundary points of negative 2/5 and 0. Note that we are using closed holes at the two points because our original inequality did include where it is equal to 0. Note that our boundary points mark off three sections on the graph, negative infinity to negative 2/5, negative 2/5 to 0, and 0 to infinity. In step 4, we want to test a point in each test interval found in step 3 to see which interval or intervals are part of the solution set. When we do this, we can choose any point in an interval to represent that interval. Once we choose this value, we will plug it into the quadratic in standard form to see if the sign is either positive or negative. Keep in mind that the original inequality in standard form is 5x squared plus 2x is less than or equal to 0. To be less than or equal to 0 means the quadratic has to be negative or equal to 0. Let's go ahead and choose negative 1 from the first interval of negative infinity to negative 2/5 to plug into this. Plugging in a negative 1 into the quadratic 5x squared plus 2x, we get 5 times negative 1 squared plus 2 times negative 1, which simplifies to be 5 minus 2, which equals 3. Since we got a positive number and we're looking for it to be negative, this interval is not part of the solution. Let's go ahead and choose negative 1/5 from the second interval of negative 2/5 to 0 to plug into this. Plugging in negative 1/5 into the quadratic, we get 5 times negative 1/5 squared plus 2 times negative 1/5. This will simplify to be 1/5 minus 2/5, which equals a negative 1/5. Since we got a negative number and we are looking for it to be negative, this interval is part of the solution. Let's go ahead and choose 1 from the third interval of 0 to infinity to plug into this. Plugging a 1 into the quadratic, we get 5 times 1 squared plus 2 times 1, which will simplify to be 5 plus 2, which equals 7. Since we got a positive number and we were looking for it to be negative, this interval is not part of the solution. In step 5, we need to write the solution set and graph this. Since we are including where it is equal to 0, this will be a closed interval, and we will use box ends to indicate that. So our final answer for the interval notation is the closed interval of negative 2/5 to 0. The graph will look like the interval notation. We'll have a boxed end at negative 2/5 and a boxed end at 0, and shade everything in between for our final answer for the graph.